In this video, we're analyzing the bounce of a rubber ball. So it's aimed horizontally at a wall with an initial velocity of 10.5 meters per second. We're given the mass of the ball as well as 0.75 kilograms, and it bounces off the wall in a total time of 0.15 seconds and turns around. But after the bounce, it's moving slower than it was originally. It's going to be moving 7 meters per second instead of 10.5. In part A, we're asked to compute the magnitude of the impulse experienced by the ball during the bounce. So remember, impulse just means change in momentum. And it's really important in this problem that we recognize the vector nature of that change in momentum. So each of these momenta has a direction. The 10.5, we'd normally call that a positive velocity, and you get a positive momentum as a result. And the 7, we can call that a negative velocity, and you get a negative momentum as a result. So we write down the change in our momentum as final minus initial. So P final vector minus P initial vector. And our final momentum here is given by the mass of the ball times final velocity. Initial momentum is the mass of the ball times the initial velocity. And now we get those velocities in, being very careful to use plus and minus signs to indicate direction. So our mass is 0.75 kilograms. Our final velocity is -7. It's leftward. And again, our mass is 0.75, and our initial velocity is positive 10.5 meters per second. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 13.125 kilogram meters per second, and that's negative, indicating that the change in momentum points to the left. So we initially started with a rightward momentum, we end up with a leftward momentum, so that change points to the left. In the question, we were asked for the magnitude, so we can just erase the minus sign. And I guess if I'm being really careful about it, I'll write the magnitude as an absolute value of delta P. And that's 13.125 kilogram meters per second. And that's it for part A. In part B, we're asked to compute the magnitude of the average force experienced by the ball during the bounce. So we have to remember that average force can be computed as a change in momentum over change in time. In other words, the impulse divided by how long it took. Now, we could write this as a vector equation. And really all that's going to do is introduce this minus sign back in, because our impulse pointed to the left, so it was carrying a minus sign. We divide by how long it took to change the momentum by that much. That's 0.15 seconds. And when we run the numbers on this, we get -87.5 newtons, indicating that the force experienced by the ball pointed to the left, which makes a lot of sense. It ran into a wall that was to the right of it. Of course, the wall was pushing back to the left. Again, in the question, we're just asked for the magnitude of this, so I'm just going to write that as F bar, average force during the collision, and that's 87.5 newtons. And part B is done. Finally, in part C, we want to find the energy lost in the collision. So right from the beginning, we noticed the ball came off the wall slower than it came into the wall, so we know some energy was lost. All we have to do is compute the initial and final kinetic energy and take the difference. So our initial kinetic energy is going to be 1/2 times the mass times the initial speed squared. We plug in the numbers, and we get an initial energy of about 41.3 joules. Our final energy, we just do the same thing, 1/2 times the mass times the final speed squared, and this is about 18.4 joules. So how much was lost? It's just 41.3, the initial value, minus 18.4, the final value. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 22.9 joules lost. And we're done with part C. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.